like the sun. I've got it for. The sound of heaven. There is no one else like you, who is faithful and ever true. Yes, my heart, my life, is a testimony. There is no one else like you, who is faithful and so true. Yes, my heart, my love, my life is a testimony. Only you are holy. Only you are holy. There is no one else like you. Jesus, you're faithful and so true. Yes, my heart, my love, my life is a testimony. Only you are holy. Only you are holy. There is no one else like you, who is faithful and so true. Yes, my heart, my life is a testimony. And he walks with me, and he talks with me, and he tells me that I am his own. And the joy we share as we tarry there, none other shall ever know. And he walks with me, and he talks with me, and he tells me that I am his own. And the joy we share as we tarry there, none other shall ever know. None other shall ever know.
One thing that you got to know, that when you worship the Lord, Jesus himself stands up on the cross. Not on his throne, rather. Jesus himself stands up in the midst of his throne. And you entertaining him. Saints, I want to say this because I've been in healing ministry for some time. I've been in deliverance ministry for some time. I'm gonna share more stuff with you at the conference. But I've learned the secret of how to tap into God's manifested glory and fire. I know how to get there. And I also know the side of Jesus where he will pit a feeling on you as if he's ignoring you. He'll do it. When you set out to seek him, he gets more reserved. Because he already has an explosion within him that he's waiting to give you. So when you set out to seek him, he gets more reserved. Because in the back of his mind, he's thinking, boy, you just don't know. If you can keep up your consistency, I'm going to explode on you. Saints, I'll never forget when I was 14 years old. I used to watch Pastor Benny Hinn. My mother used to watch TBN, and when I used to come home from school and when I used to stay home, I used to watch Pastor Benny Hinn. And when I would see the healings, I knew offhand, this is why I've been laying hands on my action figures. This is why. This is what I've been called to do. I knew it clicked with me immediately. But the time when I turned 14 years old, something began to happen to me that was very unusual. I want to say this as well. When you ask Jesus to take you over and possess you, he's going to do it. When you ask Jesus to come and live inside of you and to rule you, and thanks to my mother, I knew how to play. I knew how to pray in a stream that was very high, because I got that from my mother. My mother, when I saw her praying possess me, it was different to me, because I was like, oh, we hear about demon possession. And then the Holy Ghost got to renew your mind and open you up to a higher level of vocabulary. That possession ain't got nothing to do with the devil. The devil been stealing words that Jesus occupied for ages. Satan been robbing the very vocabulary that is pure and righteous and holy, and has been taking it as if he's the dominator to put fear in man's heart. Even having preachers put fear in their congregation's heart of the devil. People fear death. I don't fear to die. I'm always ready. I don't fear somebody. If I'm inside of a store, they say, there's a gunman here. I'm not going to get nervous. Do the gunmen know that I'm up in here too? Because me and him both going to shoot. And I'm going to use my spiritual one before my natural one. Y'all catch that later. Y'all had too much Starbucks coffee. Y'all had too much Benadryl. I don't fear to die. I don't fear this natural world or the natural system of Satan at all. I'm also going to talk to you on here about how to use the name of Jesus in prayer to stop things. This is going to be powerful, very powerful. There's a strong anointing on what I'm about to say on this line. It's already flowing right now. The things I'm going to teach you this just briefly is apostolic, is prophetic, and is governmental. Grace is from God, governmental glories. And so I had asthma, chronic asthma. And I want to teach you all this, that once you ask Jesus to take you over, your steps are ordered by him. Even the stuff that seems like you wish you could pray it off. When you ask Jesus to take over your life, even the things that you are asking him to take from you is a part of him taking over your life. Saints, I didn't get healed from asthma until 17 years old. I had the encounter with Jesus at the age of 14 years old. Afresh. First I had it at 5. The next one I had at 14 years old. I got healed at 17. But because I have this asthma on me at 14, it's a part of Jesus taking me over. This is why nothing in your life should ever stress you out or make you worry, because it's a part of him taking you over. Do you see how your life is right now? Look at where you live. Look at your city. Look at your state. Look at your job that you're working at. Look at your wayward children. Look at your rejections. Look at your misunderstandings. Look at your debts. Look at the lack of money in your bank account. All of these things is helping Jesus take you over. Every last one of them, even not having enough money. That tooth pain is not just there every now and again. There's a reason. That chest pain is not there every now and again. There's a reason. The occurrences and the seasons in your life, once you ask Jesus to take you over, to live inside of you, is for a reason. Saints, this is why Jesus said, do not let your heart be troubled. Because even what you think is trouble is not trouble. It's helping Jesus take you over. The whale's belly is not an adversary to Jonah. The whale's belly is an anointing, a fresh anointing for Jonah. The whale's belly is not keeping him away from God's plan. The whale's belly is keeping him in God's plan. Once you ask the Lord Jesus to take you over, everything has a purpose of why it happens. Every single thing. Saints, do you know that there are some people that they weren't even supposed to be in your life for more than 2 years, more than 1 year? God will let something happen because they're not supposed to be in your life. And the Lord Jesus knows that they're not supposed to be in your life. So he can't let some little patty cake occurrence take place. Even the things that are fanatic, dramatic, is Jesus taking you over. Do you know that there were some people that you was only supposed to see them one time and never talk to them again? You got their phone number. You said, girl, let's meet up again. God said, oh, all right, lean to your own understanding then. Let me just sit back here. I'm going to sit right back here and let you do your thing. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Now, go ahead. I ain't saying nothing. Nah, I didn't tell you to meet them next time. I just sent them one time to you. All right, go ahead. Do your thing. I'll let you. All right, go ahead. Go ahead, Sister Sledge. Sister Sledge hanging off the ledge. Come on, Sister Sledge hanging off the ledge. Sister Sledge hanging off the ledge. I feel my anointing of joy coming on me right now. I'm about to get real jokey on here. See, I know when each anointing comes. That's the crazy thing. That's crazy, saints. In the spirit realm, I know when the anointing of wisdom come on me for one-liners. I know when the anointing of prophecy come on me to reveal the mysteries of God. I know when I know when revelation come on me to go in depth in a teaching. I know when prosperity come on me to release wealth, to release money, angels and money encounters. I know when the anointing of healing come on me to pray for the sick. But see, right now, I feel the anointing of joy sweeping over me right now. So I'm going to get real jokey on you in just a minute. Saints, what's wild to me, do you know that when the anointing of joy come on me, I start seeing all type of funny stuff? And I start seeing angels do funny stuff. Angels of God, my angels. And so there were some people you was only supposed to meet for 3 days and that was it. You got extra connected to them. And that was never supposed to be the purpose. Saints, it's so easy to miss God. You might have one conversation with somebody and they might say everything that you're in common with. You don't know that they are psychic. They do palm reading. You get further in debt. Where you work? Well, I do something. You know, I just want to be a blessing to people. I help people. I counsel them. Oh, wow. Really? Yeah, I counsel them, and I'm always accurate with my counsel. I went to school for it, and you know what I'm saying. I went to Mount Everest. Don't you want to go to Mount Everest? I went to Mount Everest. And when I went to Mount Everest, you know, I went to Mount Everest. And don't you want to go to Mount Everest? I went to Mount Everest. Don't you want to go to college? You ain't doing nothing with your life. I went to Mount Everest. Smell like cheeseburgers. Chick-fil-A sandwich. No pickles. Mustard. You know, I do a little counseling, every now and again. And you don't know that they're telling you that they're psychic, but you don't know. Over time, you find out they're psychic, and you're like, oh! Sometimes you don't know the body of people that's even in your life that stop angels from moving. That was scheduled to move for you tomorrow. The angel can't move because there's somebody in your life that angel cannot override and minister for you with their presence, with their conversations with you. It's impossible. Now, I'm just showing you all the aspects of the spirit realm that sometimes you overlook. There are women right now that say, I've been praying for years to get healed, but I can't get my healing. And most times it's not even you. You got a friend that's connected to you. You got somebody that you talk with that is in agreement with illnesses and sicknesses on your life. They actually enjoy seeing you dependent on medicine. That's not always the case. But in some cases, some things that are in the spirit realm that's for your good is blocked because that person you're connected to is a Prince of Persia assignment. And you know what the Prince of Persia, its main ministry is to block your angel from bringing the answer. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. That's some powerful stuff. I feel the anointing on that. I feel the anointing of God on that. I'm ministering to somebody on here. You taking this word and it's going because I feel virtue. The word not bouncing back to me. So that means that you digesting it. I even know that. I know when I'm preaching and it bounced back because it's not received. You receiving it. and it's sitting in your soul and you pondering. Let me tell you something. Pondering is better than wandering. Because wandering when you leave the divine path, but pondering is where you're being quickened to the divine path. If you're taking notes, write that down. That's the wisdom anointing flowing. La kasia kantele. Fere du sakala teplesti plusti anchas teplesti cha-cha-cha-pakata. Karate tongues. When you hear me speaking karate tongues, noise on like Donkey Kong now, boy. It's on like Donkey Kong now, boy. Don't play with me. When you hear that chat 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 them on, you know it's on like Donkey Kong now. Don't play with me. Saints, since this evening I've been feeling the anointing of God go down my arms and my hands. And I just let it sit on me. And the Lord told me to let some of you all know this Welcome Holy Spirit Fire Conference is going to be full of glory and fire. I promise you, you're going to feel the fire of God hit your being, your spirit, soul, and body. Saints, there's going to be some of you all. Listen, this is going to catapult you, and we just weeks away. This is going to catapult you into your dominion for the end times. Until Jesus show up, you're going to be moving in your dominion rights. Saints, I'm telling you right now, the fire and the glory of God on me is higher than when I was in Atlanta. And it's way higher. It's way higher than when I did the meeting in Texas last year. The glory and the fire that's on me is way stronger. It's way higher. It's way more intense and boisterous and explicit. Saints, I got explicit fire on me. Screen. I mean, y'all see that. I'm trying to get this. But there's an explicit fire and glory that's on me. I'm going to be ministering off of this fire and glory in the Welcome Holy Spirit Fire Conference. It's going to be very powerful. Let me tell you something. I have fresh angels that's on my life that wasn't with me in Atlanta. I got new angels. When angels come inside of your life, you have a greater authority to release God's power. Release God's fire. And what I'm about to teach you on here is very massive, because I'm going to show you how you can stop things in the name of Jesus. I want to show you how to do it so that you could live a life that's free from slavery, oppression, and being defeated. Because it don't matter how anointed you think you are. You can be defeated if you're not using the weapons. You see? So the glory and the fire is way stronger. The impartation that I'm releasing in this Welcome Holy Spirit Fire Conference is way heavier and weightier. Because the oil that I had on me for Atlanta has actually tripled. Saints, you imagine, I pray for hundreds of people in that line. Hundreds of people. I prayed for hundreds of people. No, and just kept going. In Atlanta. So didn't miss a beat. Saints, I'm gonna tell you this. Once you get really focused, the fire of God will sit on you. Remember in the book of Acts, they was on one accord with their men of God. Remember, Peter was inside that room. They was on one accord with their man of God, their apostle. And when they and when all that took place, the fire fell. See, saints, what you got to understand is, those of you all that's connected to me, the reason why even the world is so threatened. Saints, do you, some of you all have not realized that it's not only me that torments the devil kingdom now, it's you. Because you done took on my same spirit. Some of you all have not realized that. There's some persecutions that I get that bounce off of me now, and it's coming to you because now you done receive the same like rank. And so what happened to me to get to me, get me into this glory realm with the Father, because you got to be hated by the world, is happening to you because God's saying, look, you already know what this does. It pits unimaginable power, fire, and glory, and prosperity on you. That's what it does, children. The Holy Ghost uses those things to intensify your oil supply. That's what he does. And then here's the powerful thing, what you have. You have a portrait of what happens when that happens. Saints, I was thinking about it today and the Lord had told me this. The anointing of increase is on me. I looked at my sons. I looked at some of my daughters. Y'all increasing. Why are you increasing? I watched some of you all sow $2. And I ain't say nothing to you with your big ass up. I ain't say nothing with you, player. I ain't say nothing to you, player. I just let it slide. I ain't rebuke you. I ain't do none of that. I knew you had about 50 on you. I knew you had about 50. You had a buck 50 on you. Some of you are up there sowing $800 and $700 seeds sometimes. Out of nowhere. You know that you done came up. I'm watching some of you all done grow into the sowing anointing. Some of you all only used to sow. Some of y'all in 2016 only used to send me $50. Every 2 months. Now you're up there sowing $1,000 seed. The anointing of increase is on me. Is on me. I am anointed for increase. The Lord told me that today. He spoke that to me. I am anointed for increase. Meaning I have power on me to make everything that you have in your life multiply. There's no secret. How many of y'all done received money out of nowhere this year? You see, some of y'all be forgetting. Don't forget what the Lord does. You got money out of nowhere. The anointing of increase is on me. It's on me. It's on me. Hainsley, I don't want to get too much, but Hainsley, remember I prophesied to you last year at when we was at Dr. Mike Murdoch's church. I prophesied to you and your wife. And Hainsley could testify. Hainsley ain't tell me nothing. I told Hainsley there was a deficit. Some of y'all was in that meeting. I told Hainsley in front of all y'all, I said, Hainsley, I told him and his wife, there was going to be a death that was going to take place. And when it happens, don't let it disturb you. That everything, I pray for Hainsley. Everything that I prophesied came to pass. Saints, one of my, I'm just going to say affiliates now. One of my affiliates at the time. He had then nigga got turtleneck. He was there with me, and the day before he left, I told him, I said, there's gonna be a death of someone as you return. And when they die, the inheritance that they have is going to come to you. The morning for departure gets a call on the phone, and they tell him there's a man in the family about to die on the deathbed. And they signed over land, big land that belonged to the man, into his hands. But he didn't stay connected, so all that stuff just went by the wayside. Saints, I'm telling you, in the spirit realm is real, because it don't matter if good stuff happened to you, like, if you don't stay with the will of God for your life, like, it'll just all just fall by the wayside. But no lie, as I stand before the Lord, this stuff happened. And then the stuff just went. Saints, when I talk to you and I release the miraculous in your life for money and finances, don't run off and think like, okay, I got what I was looking for, and da, da, da. You got to stay connected, because there's another level. Or if you disconnect, what you have just going to fall by the wayside. It's going to wither away. No, I'm just saying this out of love. I don't need your money. I'm trying to help you, because I'm rich soul. I'm rich. I'm highly rich soul. I'm just letting you know, because I already know it. If you following me accurately, if you listening to me with a pure heart and you following me for sure, I already know what's going to happen. So I'm not guessing, okay, is they going to get blessed? Is they going to get prosperous? Is they going to have more money? Is they going to have more favor? Is they going to have more anointing, more wisdom, more joy, more health in their body? I'm not guessing. I already know it's going to happen. But what I'm telling you is, when it does happen, not if it happens, when it does happen, stay connected to your apostle. Because, let me read this to you real quick. And this scripture in 3 John always shake me up. It shake me up, and a lot of children of God don't even know that there's a 3 John. Or a 2 John, rather. 2 John chapter 1, verse 8 says this. Look to yourselves that you lose not the things which you have wrought, but that you receive a full reward. 2 John chapter 1, verse 8. Saints, do you know what this text is saying? Huh? What this text is saying right here, saints, is telling you that look and examine at what you have produced, and don't destroy what you have produced because you don't stay in obedience to what God taught you to produce it. Easy like that. You see that? It's telling you right here in the text. That which God taught you how to produce what you have produced, don't forget it. Because if you do, you're going to lose what you produce. Look what it says. And watch this here. You're going to abort the fact that God wanted to give you a full reward. Meaning that God had just gave you something to boost you, take you higher. But there's higher and higher and higher glory. There's higher finances. There's higher health. Do you know that you can be healthy and there's glory levels to your health? You can be wise and there's glory levels to your wisdom. You can have revelation and step into the glory levels of the revelation. You can be strong and step into the glory levels of strength. You can be rich and step into the glory level of riches. There's glory levels for every single aspect of impartation that God will give to you. Every oil has a multiplication to it. You can be virtue and go to higher levels of virtue, higher glory of virtue. So you as a woman, you start becoming more of a helper, more of a servant, more of a student, more of a solution, more of a peacemaker. There is glory levels for being a king. God shows you how to dominate with even more patience, dominate with more love. So there's levels to everything. And the glory levels, the more it intensifies and intensifies and intensifies, you'll have the ability to do what you always dreamed about doing. And other people are going to see Jesus in you and going to be able to be engrafted into that same like grace, that same like knowledge, that same like wisdom. And you're going to keep on multiplying God's influence in the earth. So let's second John 1:8. Look to yourselves. That means examine yourself. Don't disregard you. Let your eyes be open to what God taught you that is a pathway to being prosperous, successful, and achieving the word in your life. And don't forget that. If the Lord tell you you're trying to stop smoking, don't hang around Eldred. And then 6 weeks go by and you and Eldred talking on the phone. And Eldred say, man, come over, man. Pull up. And you up there tell us, all right, Eldred, I'm just down the street. You got mesothelioma. You got all type of stuff in your lungs. You got the new mesothelioma. You got the mesothelioma that in the lungs. All right, Elgin, I'm down the street. All right, Elgin, I'm down the street. I'm there about 20 minutes. You talk to anybody else on the phone, they think that they talking to someone with a frog in their throat. You was on Little Rascals or something. All right, Elgin, I'm just down the street. I'm just coming up there right now. And God like, no, you not. They're up in the car talks. I just heard myself talk to myself. No, I'm not. Yes, I am. Yes, I am. No, you're not. I just heard myself talk. Yes, I am. No, you're not. God using your same voice to talk to you. No, you're not. This girl done watched Nutty Professor so long, so she saw Nutty Professor do it. So then she ain't say, yes, I am. She said, yes, I can. And God said, go ahead, dude. Go and do what you got to do. God, just step aside. Let her go do what she got to do. But she forgot that Eldred was the reason why she couldn't stop smoking last time. Erase the weed man number in your phone. This a word for somebody. Erase the weed. See, some of y'all, iPhone is taking a lot of y'all to hell. You know why? Because iPhone, that iCloud, is taking I out the cloud. Don't keep their number in the phone. Listen, it's okay for you to change your number. That iCloud will keep I out the cloud. Because you know what happened? When Satan ready to tempt you, you got the number. Come on, let's call it. Call it up. You still got it in your phone. Come on. And that go for other scenarios as well. Praise God. Let the will of God be done. Don't try to fight after you done asked Jesus to take you over. Let him do what he want with your life. Since you know how many people, they're always trying to pray for dead people when they done died. See, sometimes you gotta have wisdom with using scripture. You try to raise the dead. How you know that dead person won't come back in? Saints, some people be so bound to stuff that when they see that they made it to heaven, they be like, oh, Jesus, how did I get up in here? Jesus, you gonna have mercy on me? Come on. Abraham, y'all having a barbecue? I can come. Oh, I gotta wait till I get some more fruit. All right. What you say about next week? I can come. But y'all gonna be done eight. Wait, Abraham, don't shut the door. Abraham, hey. All right, that's cool. That's cool, Abe. That's cool, Abe. At least I'm up in here. Abe done shut the door on you. Abe said, this is a VIP party. You can't come up in here if you up there. You. Be up in heaven up there eating fruits. Angel be calling you because somebody up there done prayed you back to earth. You up there, the angel say, you gotta go back to earth. Don't knock you off of me. I'm gonna finish this orange. This a heavenly orange. Get off of me. You gotta go back to earth. The Lord Jesus is sending you back to earth. I ain't going back. Get your hands up off of me. They wake up in the bed, hooked up to all type of stuff. Jesus, what you done did to me? I was just in a Jerusalem, New Jerusalem orange. I was just in a New Jerusalem. I was just in a New Jerusalem orange. I got all these tools up in my throat. I got all the, and then it go. McDiwa up there always trying to get $8 for his music card is sitting next to me. McDiwa, how did he find me from Facebook? Always always asking me for $8, talking about Prophet Joshua Holmes sent him. Talking about beloved. How is he up? People always trying to pray people up from their dead place. In the name of Jesus, come out. Come up out from the dead. Nah, some of them people be happy to go. Let them go. You done prayed them back out of. Saints, what if Lazarus? Imagine if Lazarus was with an ugly woman. And she was just praying. And Lazarus was in there stinking for 40 days, for 4 days rather. And Lazarus, he came out because she prayed him back in. And he had all the napkins. This was Lazarus. I'm going to show you how Lazarus was. This is the perfect example I'm about to show you. This is how Lazarus was. I'm about to show you right here. Lazarus was just like this. He was just like this here. He couldn't see nothing or nothing. He was just like this here. Yeah. Lazarus, come forth, all right. And praying woman, all right. All right, the thing done fell down. Lazarus, look up. Oh, I'm not going back. I'm going back inside of this tomb. You done got me with the cookie monster, Jesus. I got free. You going to put me back here? The cookie monster done came to got that to got me. Lazarus done went back into the tomb, just played there. Just they buried Lazarus. They heard him being up from the ground up. Because Lazarus wasn't fully dead. He just went back into. So look to yourselves. That after you have wrought and produced the word of God in your life, that you don't forget and lose your full reward. Because you know your full reward is going to carry the other dreams that you had that has not manifested yet. When the Lord starts showing you the light, how you growing and you getting better, don't let the old things come back and trip you up, make you fall back into the old mindset, the old way, the old emotion, the old atmosphere. And then as a result, you find yourself aborting the bigger picture. See, saints, what 2 John 1:8 is dealing with the bigger picture. What the Lord letting you know, I'm going to give you the increase. I'm going to give you the deliverance, but don't take that deliverance and let bondage creep back up in your life and then you abort the whole package that was about to be poured out on you. Saints, let Jesus be able to romance you without you adapting to being a virgin. You see that? Stop trying to protect your virginity when the Holy Spirit want to come upon you and rest upon your life and use your life and operate with your life. Let him use you. Saints, morality is sometimes an enemy to humility. Because you know what morality do? It's your own system of righteousness that you made up. And then when it's time for God to call you forth and say, hey, you, I want to send you here. And I want to pitch you. You're going to go to this place, even though they say that it's not of God. And you're going to preach in here. And I want you to say this and do this and act like this. And if other people say, they say, no, that's not morality. That's not moral. But see, that morality will stop your humility. Then you don't want to go forth and do it. Now, you don't want to go forth and do it because somebody else is telling you that that's not of God. Well, if you know so much about God, how come you're not richer than me? How come you ain't got in my Father's house how many mansions manifested in your life? So if you're not there yet, I really appreciate your desire to protect me. All right. But baby, it looked like me and you both in the same boat. And I ain't trying to stay in this boat forever. So the Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and all his righteousness. So you trying to give me your righteousness, but your righteousness done kept you in bondage and kept you short-winded. So I'm trying to go high, baby. I can't. I'm trying to go high, baby. Don't let them use you. Don't set it off. And sometimes you gotta catch when people letting the devil use them. It keeps you, you know. You gotta beware of that. You can't let the path that God has given to you that's gonna produce the reality of everything you know that God done promised you, you can't let them detour you off that path. Because then how you gonna get what God promised you? And then when you struggling and ain't got what God promised you, they not gonna be there to lift your behind up. You know what people do when they leave, when they mess you up and leave you by the wayside? Well, I didn't make you do it. I ain't put a gun to your head, baby. I just was telling you what I felt in my heart. Now that you found out that was all wrong, that was your decision, baby. That was your decision. It wasn't me. Use the name of Jesus in your life to stop things that's not supposed to be. And you have to be aggressive about what's divine. Today I had an occurrence and I had to persevere just briefly. It was just a couple minutes. Because I'm doing something for someone else. But the person that has what I'm doing for someone else, they started acting weird. And this somebody, you know. So I had to talk some sense into the person. Had to tell them, hey, you know, this not for me. This for somebody else. I said, and this one said, I'm fulfilling scriptures. Love your neighbor as yourself. I'm doing this for somebody because they in need. I said, listen, think about it like this. You helping me do Jesus' will towards somebody that need Jesus to intervene for them. And Jesus is using me to get it to them. And he using you to listen to me to get it to them. So comply up in here. And he was like, hey, Mr. Holmes. Okay, all right. So whenever you need it, okay, we'll do this. Whenever you just tell me what to do, I'll just follow you. Yeah, whatever you command me, I'll just do it. And since I was thinking about it, if you call somebody and say, I'm going to give you $1 million to kill somebody, all right? They'll jump to the occasion and do it. But when you want to use somebody to show love, it's a fight. I was just thinking about it. He don't know that the devil using him. Because the Lord was telling me, persevere, son. Let's go at him. Let's press him. We going to deflex him. we gonna press him. We know that we busy. We know we got things to do. But we about to press. You about to learn today. You about get your hand on my feet. Your hands smell like Funyuns and onions. We going to press him. Shop. We gonna press him. You gotta go hard in the paint.
Get your hand back. Get your hand back. Get your crusty fingers back. Get your crusty fingers. You got Shaq juice all over your fingers. You were playing for the L.A. Lakers. And y'all up there got old Scottie Pippen sweat all on you. Get off of me. Get off of me. Don't calm me down. Don't calm me down. You're going to learn today. Shut up.
The Lord said, press him. And I was thinking about it. How many children of God don't get the will of God done because you don't know how to press? I thought about it. Because if I didn't obey my Father in heaven and press him, nothing gonna pop off. And watch this. Do you understand how much points I win with the Father? Because it's not for me. I'm about to say something to you that I want this to sit in your soul for all eternity. There's a level of Godship where you no longer fighting the good fight of faith to get your miracle. You start fighting the good fight of faith for somebody to get their miracle through you. This a higher level of life. And you need to know this. This is what you're sowing into. You ain't sowing into no saints. You're sowing into the God realm. Apostleship. Because I had to fight the good fight of faith for them to get their miracle. I already got mines. I'm already living in mines all day, every day. But I have to fight for them to get theirs. You know how much points I win with the Father? Do you know how much anointing I receive just from that? The Father seeing you going extra, going ham just for somebody to eat some green eggs and ham. See, I'm showing you, children, there's a higher level of life where you're not even going to the Lord consecutively about something that you need. You start going to the Lord about what someone else needs. Let me tell you something, saints. I'm going to give you a law in the spirit. James say, pray for one another that you may be healed. If you asking God to heal you constantly and your stuff's still the same, start going to the Lord in prayer about other people. Saints, do you know that when I wanted to get healed from asthma, right? And I realized that the asthma was still on me. Guess what I started doing? Father, in Jesus' name, I come before everybody with asthma. I come before you for everybody that has asthma. In the name of Jesus, I pray that their asthma will go. I pray that they'll be healed from taking that albuterol, the medicine. I pray that they'll be delivered from all those wheezing and all those restless nights where they can't breathe. Father, in Jesus' name, I loose healing upon their body. I decree that they're healed. See, some of you all, I'm giving you wisdom on here. Father, in Jesus' name, everybody that got high blood pressure, I decree that they're healed. I decree that they're delivered. Everybody that got heartburn, Father, I pray that their heartburn will go. I pray that their healing will come for heartburn. All of your people all across the world, wherever they're struggling with heartburn, in the name of Jesus, I pray for their heartburn to go. I started sowing seeds and praying for other people to get a house. Now I got a house. Money coming to me now. Money coming to me now. I started praying for them to get a house. And when I'm the one that sowed the seed, I'm praying for them to get a house for. I'm praying for them to. Say, so I was at the dealership trying to get a car, right? I sowed my seed, named my seed, and then I started praying for everybody that wanted a car. I said, Lord, everybody that's believing you for a car, I decree right now that they receive their car. I come into agreement, I touch with you, that everybody that's walking right now, they don't have to walk no more. Every one of your child, I pray for miracles in their transportation. Do you understand what you're doing in the spirit realm? Money! Says glory to God. Glory to God. Because you done found the law in the spirit. Once you done found the law in the spirit, you operate in this law. It's going to work for you. Love your neighbor as yourself will introduce you to neighbors that's going to love you back. See, the second commandment, greatest commandment that Jesus gave was carrying men giving into your bosom. Ho, 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 ho. Hallelujah. Glory to God. It's carrying a connection to investors. See? When I'm teaching on sowing, I was thinking about today, it helped me. See, saints, some people, they can watch you, hear you talk about money, and they think, oh, a person just about money. You stupid fool. While I'm talking about sowing, I'm increasing my sowing anointing in my life, because every day I sow. There are teachings that I teach on sowing that take me to the next level in my sowing. Jesus is talking about sowing, and his own teachings is helping him sow. Jesus is talking about giving, and his own teaching is helping him give. Because the Bible said Jesus went around doing good. So Jesus' own impartation, correction, is ricocheting back to him. And they're benefiting off of his wisdom, but Jesus is benefiting off of his own wisdom. While Jesus teaching them about giving, then Jesus says it's more blessed to give than to receive. And so Jesus constantly going around and giving. Why? Because Jesus' own teaching is making him even more anointed to go around and invest. Why didn't Jesus look at Jairus and said, oh, you ruler of the synagogue, I know what you all are about. You just want to use my power for this miracle? Just for you to betray me? Huh? Guess what? Guess what? You know what to do. You know what to do. You know what to do. Jesus went right there and rose the girl up. And he had to persevere. Because remember, the people was laughing at Jesus. So Jesus could say, y'all want to disrespect me up in here? I ain't doing nothing. And then Jairus, you got any people up in here? I'm out. You feel me? 504, Jerusalem. We gang gang. Saying some of them Jerusalem people was gangsters and mobsters. You know they was, because they tried to stone folk. What? I'm from America, man. I don't understand that. Listen, you sound like Daffy Duck, man. You see, I don't know what you watch, PBS Kids. What you, this a Disney prank? Where Ashton Kutcher gonna come out? I'm on my punk. The Jerusalem edition. I don't know what you just said, bro. I don't know what you just said. Listen, Daffy Duck.
Hey, Daphne, don't do it to me. Don't do it to me. Don't, Daphne, oh, shoot, you done do that. Let me go. Oh, shoot, oh, they shoot it. They shoot it. Somebody call 911. Tupac, all eyes on me. They done shot me again. Hey, I didn't know that you were telling me that you from the 504 Jerusalem. Boys, you done shot me in my back. I'm going to see Jesus. Father, forgive me all my sins. I shouldn't have smoked last night. You told me not to smoke. I'm sorry. In Jesus' name, amen. I rest my peace. All the dead homies. Now, them people from overseas, them people from overseas be crazy. Look at ASAP Rocky. You know, man, the man kept on following him. That man was a little chihuahua, but he was crazy. Says, I saw the video. They took that man, they swung him, they brought him here, and brought him down. And then brought him back all the way over here. And they brought him all the way back over here. This was him just like this, and they had him, threw him all the way over here. Get yourself back over here. Bring yourself back over here, man. I'm about to get you. You're not going to learn today. Brought him here and then brought him there, like Martin Mama. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Look what he said right here in John chapter 14. Yeah, John chapter 14, verse 14. He said, if you shall ask anything in my name, I will do it. If you shall ask anything in my name, I will do it. Saints, do you know how powerful this is? The Lord letting you know in this text that his name carries weight for receptivity in the spirit realm and in the earth realm. What he telling you, see, some of you all need to start doing this. You start decreeing that you're not going to have no cold this winter, this fall. Start decreeing you're not going to get no flu. See, saints, I want to show you something in the spirit realm. Deal with things before they even show up. You got, and see, your mind got to be in the spirit for the Lord to even bring about what to aim at with your authority. Because sometimes everything could be going cope and steady and God will start whispering to you about stuff. And you're like, well, none of that stuff happening to me. So why should I even speak on it? I ain't trying to speak on it. But God's saying, I know that, fool. That's why I'm telling you, I already know that's not happening to you. But I'm looking beforehand. Remember the Bible said a prudent man foresees evil and hides himself. A prudent man foresees evil. So the Lord will start whispering to you on what to use your authority against. Saints, I've seen car accidents happen right in front of my vehicle and then touch me.
I remember one time on the highway, the vehicle was coming. I'm driving like this. The vehicle had swung out of control, spin in front of my vehicle, hit the other vehicle, bam, shatter back, and I'm right there. They didn't get touched. Yeah, I kept on driving out. I think I had warrants out for my arrest back then. I don't know. So I kept on driving. I wasn't going to answer no questions. I try to ask you questions, and you're not prepared. You ain't got your tag on your car that day. Somebody had stole it because you was at the hood gas station, the hood 7-Eleven. You gotta be suspicious of that brother that's in the hood always doing his hands like this at the gas station, like he about to pull out a cigarette, and he looking at your ties. He want to take one of them and sell it for $25. Don't play with them. And you be seeing their pants all baggy, be suspicious. Cause they got a wrench. They got the hijacker right there inside of their pocket carrying it around. You wonder why they can't take that step real good. They up there walking like this and lifting their knees up. Why you gotta lift your knees up that high when you're walking? Why you gotta lift your knees up? Why you gotta lift your knees up? You ain't gotta lift your knees up just to take a forward progress. Why you gotta lift your knees up when you're walking? You ain't gotta lift your knees up that high just to come through. Walk normal. But he got a whole wrench. You go inside trying to get you some chips. You come out, the whole car done gone. The whole car. He done took the donut. Since you know you be seeing them cars, it be crackhead activated. When you see them cars on side of the highway where the tire is gone and it's just sitting up on a brick. When you see that car sitting up on a brick, it's crackhead activated. Just remember that prophetic word, it's crackhead activated. Why only one of the tires is gone? Huh? It was a whole tire right there. Why one tire just gone and it's on a brick? Who had the brick awaiting to pick the car up? Crackhead activated. Whatsoever you ask in my name, I will do it. Which shows you that the name of Jesus has creation power. The name of Jesus has apostolic authority to move things in your direction. The name of Jesus is a magnet in the spirit realm. When you use the name of Jesus, you magnetizing things to you. So when you use the name of Jesus, things start coming to you that are the will of God for your life and the things that are your will for your life. Because the Lord go, watch this here. The Lord is so powerful and he made you such a God. He made you in the God realm like him. So he going to pick his will and manifest in your life, but he also going to give you a will that's inspired by his will that he going to manifest in your life as well. A double portion. And it's all the perfect plan of God. And he enjoys it. Glory to God. Glory to God. While he teaching you to do his will, you're permitting God to do your will. Says, did you catch that? How many of y'all just caught that? While you're being taught to do God's will, you're inviting him to do your will. So God will start doing your will when you master doing his will. And the beautiful thing about it, your will not be contrary to what will bring him pleasure too. The things that you'll have an appetite for is actually what he's putting in you to have an appetite for. Saints, let me just give you a secret. When you're doing what God say, he going to start giving you an appetite for more. And then he going to supply you with the more so that you can love him more. Because you love him because he first loved you. So that means that your love for Jesus can't grow until he reveals to you how much he loves you. When he reveals to you how much he loves you and you get the revelation and it sits inside of you, you start loving him more. You see that? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because you love him because he first loved you. You don't love him because you loved him all your life. You don't love him because you loved him since you was a child. You love him because he first loved you. And when you get a revelation of the first love, you can flow out of that same realm of loving him first. That first love realm will make you put Jesus above every single thought, feeling, and option that you have in your life. And he'll always be the number one go-to for your obedience to be invested in. If you take notes, write this down. I said this. Mercy, obedience is a divine reaction to mercy. Servanthood is a divine reaction to favor. And loyalty is a divine reaction to power. So wisdom doors, those are fresh. Obedience is a divine reaction to mercy. Servanthood is a divine reaction to favor. And so many things coming to me right now. Consistency is a celebration for God's patience towards you. Write that down. Consistency is a celebration for God's patience towards you. When you're consistent, you're telling the Lord, thank you for being patient with me. Consistency is actually when you grow to appreciate God's compassion towards you. Consistency. Let me say it like this, and this is real powerful. I want to elaborate on this. This is wisdom here. Consistency is when you do the same. But diligence is when you think the same. Consistency is when you do the same. But diligence is when you think the same. Remember the word of God said that he's a rewarder of those that diligently seek him? Well, he's saying that the heart never became impure. It kept on thinking, I need Jesus. I want to go after him. I want him to tell me what to do. I want him to rule me. So the diligence, the reason why he rewarding you, because he know that inwardly you after his own heart. You don't ever want to step outside of his instructions. So diligence is really a mindset. And consistency is a conduct set. Consistency is where you do the same. Diligence is where you think the same. So now you know why God is going to reward those that diligently Seek him because you're constantly thinking about seeking him. You're not seeking money. You're constantly thinking about seeking him. You're not seeking healing. You're constantly thinking about seeking him. You're not thinking about sex. Moving along. Gia's laughing at me. You know Jesus had fun with me, right? Jesus, there are some churches that Jesus done, he left on Sunday and he come sit right next to me. You know that, right? Because he like when he can joke around people. He love when he can joke around people. Saints, do you know that Jesus could be joking around something and then somebody that is an enemy to Jesus is in the presence of that, and then they get mad. Oh. Jesus never got angry until he saw Lucy. Jesus never got angry until he saw the serpent in the garden. Jesus created you to laugh and talk with him. That's why he sent the apostle, the prophet, to help perfect you so that you can step into this realm of laughing and talking. Saints, I have to say this because the Lord spoke this to me within 48 hours. And he bringing this to my remembrance, so I'm going to say it now. The reason why you all hear wisdom that's not being preached nowhere in this world is fresh. Is because you sow into me. The Lord watch how people handle their leader. Like if your leader going all the way in and you just like, all right, thank you for that word. You helped me out. Thank you. I'll see you. Bye. Bye-bye. You sow. You value me. You respect me. So when Jesus see our unity, he pour out oil. Just like on Aaron, on Aaron's beard. Psalm 133. See, unity releases fresh oil. So when God see the unity and he see the honor, it releases apostolic power to be witnesses and great grace to have no lack. Saints, the anointing for no lack, the anointing of great grace, it deals with every aspect of your God lifestyle. Because if you got no lack, that means that there's no area where satanic activity is governing you. You have no lack in your mind, so you don't lack wisdom. You don't lack divine knowledge. You don't lack truth. You don't lack conviction. You don't lack direction. You don't lack discernment. Your mind is full. No lack deals with your body. You don't lack strength. You don't lack energy. You don't lack power. You don't lack durability. You don't lack flexibility. Moving along. You don't lack flexibility. I said moving along, nigga. You can't interrupt my broadcast when I'm up here talking. You don't have no fatigue. You don't have no fatigue. What's going on? The no lack anointing. See, the don't lack anointing, it works for every aspect of your life. The don't lack anointing will stop all plots, purposes, and problems that Satan will send from his kingdom. The no lack anointing. Say, Father, I received the no lack anointing. Glory to God. See, saints, it's not that I'm just a sower. I am entertaining the no lack anointing. Because I refuse to let the devil have any place in any area of my life. Oh. So it's not just I'm sowing. I'm really just moving in revelation that I wasn't created for no lack. Oh my God. So when you start working kingdom principles, it's because you've been quickened. Oh, you've been quickened and you realize that you wasn't created to have Satan mocking you in no area of your life. He don't got a voice in no area of your life. No power in any area of your life. No authority in any area of your life. No place in any area of your life. When you start moving in power in the name of Jesus, no demon gonna be able to get through that name of Jesus. No demon gonna get through that authority in the name of Jesus. You got the power to inherit all things. You got the power to govern all things. You got the power to walk in all things. Oh, come on, somebody shout hallelujah. Because that's what the name of Jesus do. It's pulling down strongholds. It's canceling evil. The arrow that flies by day, it can't keep on flying when the name of Jesus is being spoken out of my mouth. The terror by night, it can't touch me when the name of Jesus is flowing out of my mouth. 1,000 falling at my side, it can't touch me because the name of Jesus coming out of my mouth. And 10,000 at my right hand, it will not come near me. Why? Because I got the name of Jesus coming out my mouth. I not only got the name of Jesus coming out my mouth, but I got the name of Jesus on me. I got the name of Jesus on me. He put his name to sit 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 on me. His name is sitting on me. They not only had tongues of fire sitting on them, they had the name of Jesus sitting on them. That's the reason why they was able to talk in a supernatural language. Because they got the name of Jesus sitting on them. They got the name of Jesus sitting on them. They got the name of Jesus sitting on them. The reason why. It said that you've been made to sit in the heavenly places in Christ because you got the name that is above every single name sitting on you. So you got the authority to sit in the heavenly places. No principality, power, ruler of the darkness of this age, spiritual host of wickedness in the heavenly places can stop you from sitting down because you got Jesus' name sitting on you. Yeah. Who it was? Rosa Parks? Well, that's how it is. No demon can remove you from sitting down. Because you got the name of Jesus sitting on you.